I guess we want to keep the running thread going. I didn't even think about this. I was just about to go to sleep. And so, oh, what a mess. I was going to put some stuff on. Never mind. Well, let's see how it works. There you go. It works. I am very happy about that. Okay. That's pretty smooth. Don't do this to me. I guess you gotta pull off real slow. Well, let's see what the rest of it does. Well, that was easy. That was easy! And then that. And then... How much do you pay for stickers? And how many of you have, you know, stuff with those films over it that you never take off? What are you waiting on? It's going to get better. So I did do the great stuff here. I'm going to have to do the caulking here. Boy, I got to tell you, I like the ergonomic look of that too. That's very nice. Any old tramps out there? I don't guess so. Okay. Sweet! I gotta get this room finished. It's just getting to be out of hand here. I gotta clean up and dust and everything else, but I can't tell I finish this drywall, but that's not gonna be the point today, because I got a couple more coats of stuff to do, but it's getting there. It's getting there, it's fine. It'll be fine. So, it just makes such a mountain of mess. But speaking of mountain of mess, oh good, all my stuff stayed there. I'm gonna try to finish out this window today. So one of the most interesting things about this is this wire coming here. I really couldn't do much else with it, and I didn't want to drill holes. I barely had enough wire to get it over here. But my thing is going to be, I'm going to make a spacer and hide this wire in the trim work itself. So I've got to kind of think about that and come over here, but I don't know. So I'm going to make the inner panels. I've got I couldn't get that all the way in for whatever reason. There's probably a screw on the siding or something, but I don't care. So I'm going to make a shim here, and then make a cover shim out of quarter plywood, and then we're going to finish this out. I got some 1x3s yesterday. I'm going to paint those white. I'm going to cover this up down here, and Reliabuild. I tell you the truth, it's a pretty good little window. It's about 30 degrees out there, so let's not leave that open very long. So, all right, and we had some rain already, and so there's that silicone from last time. Gotta wait for that to cure and scrape it off with a straight razor. So, very nicely done here. I'm okay with this. I don't think I'm going to get a storm window for this one, but anyway, well, let's go in there, and I got these cheap cabinets, so a little dedication to my old friend Bob Witherspoon. Witherspoon's Rose Culture. He was a fine man, and I miss him very much. And Thelma. So what I've already done here is, and you might wonder what the Scott paper towels are doing there. I'll show you in a minute. So I've already got everything drawn out. Everybody's dimensions are going to be different, so it doesn't really matter what my measurements are. So I'm going to cut everything a little big. I'm going to put all my saws, my miter saw and my table saw, my traveling table saw on the trailer and bring up here. And I'm going to be able to cut and fit this thing. So there's where we are, and that's kind of the way I do it. So there's that where I got to make the shims at the top. That's my overall dimensions. There's that wire and I'm all that other stuff. So a lot of the wood I'm going to use is going to be coming from what I cut out to put the window in, because it's half inch, and that's pretty useful in these kind of projects, and will be on several places on this window. And I got a piece of quarter plywood yesterday. So one would wonder, what am I doing with this? Well, I guess I'll keep going. I'm going to make a dispenser. The dispensers for these things are crazy expensive. So I'm going to make a dispenser, and I'm going to put it on this door, on the back of the door. See? And that's where I did the stained glass stuff. So there is, I'm gonna mount it right here. And that's just going to be a little side project, a little something just kind of be nice. So whenever I need a paper towel, see, but I don't really like paper towels sitting out for whatever reason. I never did. And when I was a boy, we always had them behind the door. But they always smell like trash because trash can was there. So I'm going to put it up high, and I'm going to make my own little dispenser and put right here, make it out of quarter plywood, and it ought to fit fine. It's a perfect dimension almost for this. And there's my Stromberg carburetor and my hop-up kit and the tarantula and the judge's stand and my Andy Griffith clock and everything else. So kind of fun. All right, well, let's get to work. All right, I've got them all cut. There's A, B, C, and D in pieces, and E in pieces, and E, F, or F, E, F, G, you know, Foxtrot, Golf, Hotel, Indigo. Okay, so I think I got them all. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, got them. So all those are cut now, so we're going to go up there and fit them. So I got my miter saw over there because, you know, y'all's trim is always a little finicky. So, all right. Well, let's see. I think while I'm down here, I got that big hunk of quarter. I'm going to go ahead and sort out what I'm going to do for this towel box, because I'd like to get that together tonight if I could, but I don't know if I can. One of the most difficult things to do in carpentry is make a box. When you're pretty good at making a box, then that's all right then. So I'll go into more detail on this later, but I'm going to assemble it. I got me a napkin to measure with. Never thought I'd say that. Always put my blade down. Always keep it in if you're not using it. That's a fairly respectable box I got going there, sort of loosely held with tape. So I got to go see if it's going to work up on my cabinet, and then I'll go from there. And here's my paper towel. So, okay. So she'll have to, I think that's okay. I think I can take it in some and kind of do the tighten up on it, but let's just go give it a test fit up on the cabinet. Just love stuff like this. Gave her two coats. That's the trim around the window. I got to get it in so the dew won't get on it, but look at that right there. Got to set zoom fast on it. So I got up about 4:30 or 5 this morning, and man, it was right there in my bay window. It's just so beautiful. I didn't film it though, but if it happens again, I might. Okay, well, let's get all this stuff up there, see what I can do. I'd like to get that window boxed in tonight. Okay, whew, cold out there. Well, let's see about fitting this, the spacers in here. Okay, and that'll go fine. I got a pneumatic tool coming in this door in a second. Oh, what a mess. So my preference is to make things a little big in this kind of situation, and then kind of work my way down, sort of sneak up on it a little bit. So let's see, that's about to fall in, but okay, it's gonna fit inside these ledges here. It's too tall because it's gonna hit that shelf, and it's too thick. But I think, by Jove, I just about have it. So, okay, well, that'll give me something to work with. and I can square it up and just make it better and better every time I mess with it. How about that? Okay, let's go. I got the air pumped up. Let's get the Metabo. How many things I got in there? Okay, I got a couple in there. Pre-cutting, you still got to mess around some, but that's nice and boxed in up there. And we're getting ready to cover up that nastiness down there. And I don't have that much more to do tonight. I got to wait and do the trim tomorrow. And we'll be hiding all that great stuff here pretty soon like we did up high. That's pretty fair. Looks like more drywall work. Well, you knew that was going to happen. So that's boxed in. Doesn't it look a lot better? Okay, well, let me get a little caulking and a little bit of drywall stuff, and we'll trim it out tomorrow and look great. That, maybe not so much. I did a little bit of other work today, and I'm going to address this. Let me see it better with the light off. You can maybe, but you see that? There's a crack going along there. So I'm going to, and don't tell anybody, but it ain't going to be in line with that beam. But I'm going to go ahead and screw up my 2x4s to, come on, baby. It don't matter because it kind of reflects funny on the thing anyway. This LED may be doing the wavy gravy too. So let me get that beam up there. I think I can clear enough area out of here to do that. And I kind of really want to get that started and get it off the back porch. Alrighty, so there's that one, and there's that one. So that's not bad. Hides the crack and looks cool. Looks structural, don't it? But, okay, so it's 2.5 feet or 3 off that. Okay, still, that's done. It's just a dimensional lumber, 2x4, 1x3s, and you can cover up a great big crack. And avoid doing other things you don't want to do. So there's that one. That one's actually made out of a cedar. This one's made out of stained pine. But I don't think anybody's going to call me on this. So if you've got a work project and you got one of these LED lights, you take the cover off, and it's pretty bright. It doesn't disperse the light as beautifully, but it makes a better work light. And if you're painting the ceiling, you got to take that down anyway. So that's looking pretty good, and my frame's looking pretty good. I'm going to get some caulk out, and it's amazing how much better it looks when you close it in like that, isn't it? So normal amount of deflection and stuff like that. I think it's fine, and when the trim will help kind of even that out some. I don't think I'm going to do that this morning. Probably be later tonight or tomorrow. That 1x3 sure hides a lot of sins, doesn't it? See, that's looking pretty good there. Let me turn the light on that I spoke of earlier. And got a little, that lower right corner is a little tricky because of the backboard, but I can caulk it. But overall, the frame fits really well. I'm going to make a little bit more of a shelf out here at the bottom. I got enough quarter inch plywood to swing it, and I probably just bring a little lip over that, but that's pretty good right there. Okay, it's messy looking, but it's really just something that was on it when I got it. So that's my trim work, and it went pretty quick. Well, I got the shades up there, and that helped hide even more evil. Now, these kind of shades require these fancy clips here. Well, maybe they don't. So, let's take a look up here. Let's let some light in. So, what I did was, they want you to hang these on the inside. Well, I didn't want to do that. So, what I did was, I just screwed it directly. See that screw right there? And there's one over here. And I just screwed it directly to the backboard. It can't be more solid than that. And that's all you need. And I just thought that was something you got to do sometimes. Sometimes, you know, necessity is a mother. So I had this, these were extra, these blinds, this blind. I got another one over there too. But I like this sort of dappled look here, and it works just splendidly. And it's up there better than with them clips. And I don't see any reason you'll be taking them down anytime soon. And they're just perfect, other than they won't spring back a little bit. But that's okay. That's their maximum travel there, and that's fine. And if I need to, I'm not gonna be sleeping in here or anything. So that hides a little bit of work. I don't have to do that. So there you go. You gotta be creative sometimes. See, these things cost $35-something for one of those. You can buy a lot of paper towels for $35. I can buy a great big hunk of 4x8 plywood, a quarter inch thick or whatever, for that much. Less than that. So that's why I'm making my little towel dispenser. I'm going to make two. I'm going to make one for the shop too. It won't be so pretty though, but it will be effective and useful. This is kind of a scary way to do this, but you got to cut a slot in the bottom of the paper towel dispenser. It's about an inch wide, but you want to preserve these edges for strength and something to glue to. So I'm going to do the old drop the blade, drop the workpiece on the blade and sort of watch it, remembering the circle of that. And then I pulled out this old boy here. Last time you used one of those, gang. This is a pretty thing too. See, it's got all that fancy work on. I have no idea how old this is. Looks like it had some repair work done on it when it busted. To me, that looks like pecan, but I don't know. So we're gonna be using that too. So let's do this. And this is a real dangerous way to do it. But I wouldn't use a jigsaw because it's too rackety and vibrate-y. So let's see if we can just do this. And let's see, what is it? It's 221. Let's see how long this takes. Probably take me, let's say 7 minutes. So the blade is just high enough to just pierce the top of this, so a little over a quarter inch on blade height. And you see, you got to be careful when you do this because you end up right on the limits where you can't see. So you got to remember, not only is it measuring for the curve, but it's also measuring for the way the blade attacks it. So I decided to mount it in the vise. I've already done that side, and you can just eat that right up, don't it? Try not to hit the metal. Okay, now I'm gonna just get my Dremel and cut out these here and here. I need both hands. But anyway, there's what you end up with, like that, and I'll be fine. Now this is gonna be a very fragile piece, so be mindful. So let's what'd it take me? I had a call, so it took me about 7 or 8 minutes, maybe 10. And then you end up with this. But let's get our dimensions in assembly, because how you assemble a box matters. It does matter greatly, because, you know, size changes and whatnot. Oop. And I'll go over all the sizes in a second, because I've done this playing around. Let me get it kind of constructed, and then I'll take it apart and show you what it looks like. And I will hope that this evening we will have it functional. So there you go. So let's just go over all the dimensions here. So here's the bottom. That's about an inch wide slot. I guess it's going to work. I don't know yet. But it's 10 and a quarter is going to be a common thing. 4 1/8 wide here. At the bottom, the top is going to be a little bit wider because you need to have it so you can lift it up. So that's 10 and a quarter by 4 1/2. And then the sides are both the same. 6 15/16 by 3 5/8. Okay. And the front, it's going to be the same. It's a 10 1/4, 6 7/8. And there you go, 6 7/8, 10 1/4. So I think we're about ready for assembly. Now you don't want to glue the top on. I got a little hinge sitting back there already to do that. So put that aside. But you're going to build the majority of the box here in a second with some glue. And I got some water here to activate the Gorilla Glue. Because it is getting late. 2:34. Clamp on a roll, right? Okay. So I've got it set up and sort of squared against my fence right there. I've got it together. I'm gonna put some backing pieces in there, but we're gonna let this firm up for a while, and I'm gonna go rebuild that Bosch framing nailer thing. So let's just now leave it alone. See, I've only been working on it like maybe 40 minutes, just sort of playing around. But let's see. So I guess I'm gonna go get the hinge. So I'm just gonna put a little single hinge on it because it's not like it's holding anything. You know, it's just a trap door basically. So I was looking through my stash and I found this hinge right here. So I've got to figure out how I'm going to do it. But I think that's going to be good enough for me to, get in both places. I think I can. Well, I don't know. I've got this little bit bigger hinge. Let's just make it as ugly as possible. You only need one hinge. You could do a cloth hinge here if you really felt like it. I've done many a cloth hinge, so it would go like this with the pin on the outside. I think I'd rather do that. And I got a couple little black brass screws, 632, it don't matter. Whatever you end up with. These are the hinges off those bifold doors I took out of the house, try to get a little space going. So when you put hinges on, go it at 90 and just square it up right there, be fine. Alrighty, we have the hinge on here, and it's going to end up sort of looking like that when it's all said and done. But we have to account for, I probably will put a couple of strips here, glue strips to get past the way the thickness of this hinge, and so let's see how that sizes up perfectly. I got enough strips from making it fit to, I think that's the way to do it. Now, I'm just going to glue this to the cabinet. I'm not going to bolt it because I can't, because the bolts would be on the outside of the cabinet. So I think this will be a relatively permanent addition to the kitchen. And I don't know if I'm going to paint it or stain it or whatever, but I don't know. I kind of like the old rustic look. Character, you know. It's a little time later, and I've glued in my little splines down there, just a little something to buck it up, you know, those little corners, and just give it a little bit more strength. So let's go ahead and see it. Well, I want to mount this tonight, I really do. So I'm going to go ahead and put me some little glue strips on the back there. Well, it kind of worked. I have an F28WW, and it says that this kit fits this. Most of it does. I'm ready to plug it in here in a second, but not F28WW. But yeah, I know. So these are most all the O-rings. This is something I'm trying to do something, because it came with some other stuff that was totally unrelated. And my trigger mechanism is different, so let's plug it up. And I got my ear stuff on and my full face mask here, and we're gonna see if it's gonna, because used to be when you plugged it in, it just blew air like crazy. I got nails in it. A little scared. Well, okay, she ain't leaking. Okay. Well, let's see if we can just nail this stuff together here. You ready? Whoa! Gosh, he's just as quiet as a mouse. Yep, that worked okay. Well, $31, that's worth it. Noise alert. Okay. Not a bad thing. I don't know what was leaking. I just changed everything I could. But this trigger mechanism is a little different.
from the ones that they said the repairman's never seen a model just like yours, huh? It worked good. It worked easy. So I'm happy with that. So let's see. I didn't need any circlip pliers like it said, but that's it. N89 ORK, O-R-K. Okay. All right. Back in action. I want to say too that you when you oil this, I'm gonna oil it right now with my pneumatic oil. Whenever you do this, if you even just pull the trigger, and the oil will go down in there better. Just release the pressure there, and it's a better thing. Okay, can't do that. Well, I guess I could, but maybe I could show you. So if you well, you can't really see it, but just do that and let it. Don't put too much oil in there. You know the other trick. If you need a little bit more action on your air tools when you're working on stuff, put a little oil in it, and it gives you a little bit more juice. No pun intended. Gives you a little bit more air pressure there to drive in nuts and bolts or get them out or whatever. So, okay. Well, let's put her on the shelf. I'm just going to let her sit there for a bit. Okay. And I'm back to my napkin dispenser here in a minute. Time for a little test shot here. I got some down in there. Looks like they're a little crooked, but I guess that'll work out. So there's paper towels in there, and there's one hanging right there. So, welly welly. That's cool. I'm happy with that. Let's put the lid on it. I think I saved $33 out of $35. That's pretty good. I'll take that. We're going to use that to clamp her up to the door. Here we are, ready to mount this thing up. And so I'm going to clean right here, and I am going to see how this goes in a minute. Let's let these off. I put in some other little squaring pieces in there so it's nice and square. Just to kind of buttress it up some. And then that's going to go up there. And that, let's just push back on that. So, well, I'm going to drop it and break it if I'm not careful. Oh, okay. It's those pieces I put on there. See those pieces I put there? It's a glue strip kind of a thing. Hey, that was lucky. I was able to drop that down some. I'm gonna need both hands, but we're gonna glue this thing up here and clamp it and everything here in a short order. My quick grip clamps aren't gonna swing it, so they're just not gonna fit this. So I'm gonna once again use clamp on a roll, and we're going to tape it up there overnight or for a little while. And I gotta clean all this off, get that soot off. I'm always fighting that soot from the old stove catching on fire. I wasn't here when that happened. So let's clean all this off and see about getting this on there and wet it up a little bit. You know the drill. And I'm gonna put something under here so in case if it drips, which I don't think it will. I'm not gonna even worry about it. I have ceramic tile here, but you know, I use this plexiglass here to kind of soften the blow a little bit. So let's see how this works. All cleaned off. Luckily I had some paper towels. And then we're just going to dribble on. I would say this just needs a minimum amount of glue. I mean, we're just holding up paper towels here. It's nothing. I've already kind of pre-wet everything. And that should be more than enough to make this thing work. Okay, and not make it, wish I could have you with me here. I'm gonna keep you in real time, I think.
Maybe I could put it here and we could see what's going on.
Oh, dinner's ready.
All right, thank you. Stop. Thank you.
So there's where we're going with this thing. And I'm going to hook it right there. And smear it in a little bit. And that's the great thing about Gorilla Glue. Is that takes up some space. Well, what a messy video, huh? So there. That's my battery charger. I'm going to fly that crazy airplane here one of these days. So, okay, so I'm going to try to. Come on, there you go. So we got it taped up there. And we'll push that back there. Okay. I have almost no sense of taste on almost any level. And, but I'll tell you, I have found that whatever this brand of, that's a better wine than that wine. So I drink a lot of stuff. And, so that's better. Okay, so there we go. I was wondering what was wrong. So this is a good test shot here, so. What am I? I seem like I'm hitting something. I must be hitting on that far side over there. So I'm going to shift it over here. Well, it's the next day. And we're going to see how this works. I don't think that was going to affect anything, so. She looks nice and square. The lid seems to work okay. Okay, so ought to just close right up. There you go. Well, they always do that. They never really work well. It's probably just right here. Let's see if that. Yeah, these cabinets are, I would say, kind of low-grade dog food. But they're okay. Okay for a barn, I mean a cabin. There you go, that's better. So I got a little bit more adorning to do and a little bit more checking out. But there you go. See, all you got to do now, when you're standing at the sink, you just go over here and you just pull yourself one down. I'm not going to load it quite yet. Look at that. Even stays up. Say. A little chalky, just the way I want it. And recycled some. I think I... Why is it moving so much? Oh, it's just a... That's funny, isn't it? Why does it do that? I guess that thing here's not tight. It really doesn't matter. So, there we go. One, two more steps. That's right. All right, there you are. Way to clean the counters there. What does this clock have to do with a paper towel dispenser? See these holes here? There was something there that I didn't want there. This thing's a little bit too looked at all the time to be so gingerbready, I guess is where I've got my tomato all boiled and ready to go. Okay, it's final shot. Here we go. You ready to see it? Ta-da! I'm going to think of something to put in here, but anyway, it's done. And done and done, and I like the little being a little floppy. So look what's in there. We got paper towels in there. And here we go. Works like a charm. And you close the door. And that's it. All right, well, that's all. So be sure and give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and we'll go back in that back bedroom as much as I don't want to. And I do some caulking and sanding. And I actually forgot about some stuff I had down in the barn that I think is going to work well in there. Kind of struck me the other day. Hey, I got that. But we'll worry about that later. That's going to be a closeout on this one. And let's look out. Nothing going on in the sky other than the pretty clouds. All right. Bye-bye, guys.